All right, let's talk some Cowboys. They already secured the division title, had nothing to play for except momentum heading into the playoffs, taking on the Giants. Dak Prescott played the whole game, threw for 387 yards, 4 touchdowns. Some good mojo for the Cowboys as they prepare for the Seahawks now in the opening round of the playoffs. Here is Dak on his mindset playing in a supposedly, quote, meaningless Week 17 game.
Going into this game, playing the New York Giants, wanting to get win number 10, this meant a lot to us, and you saw it out there, just the intensity that we played with, the ups and the downs, and just how we stayed through it and just stayed free win.
All right, Nick, I mean, how dangerous, after what you saw from this Cowboys team yesterday, how dangerous is this Dallas team?
Yesterday didn't change my overall opinion of them, which is of all the teams in the NFC field, they're the one that I would fear the least. However, I do think what they did yesterday in a meaningless game was very meaningful. I think the ability for Dak Prescott, who's the only reason that I don't have faith in this team, is their passing game, is their inability to create big plays down the field. The ability to give Dak Prescott that type of confidence going into the postseason, where you didn't have any of your all-pro offensive linemen, you didn't have your all-pro running back, you couldn't get the running game going at all, 22 carries for 50 yards, and he has statistically one of the best games of his career that culminates with two of the best plays of his career. That 4th and 15 to Beasley is spectacular, but it would have been meaningless if he doesn't extend the 2-point conversion and find Michael Gallup coming across his face in the back of the end zone. Like, for Dak, we know Dak is limited. I don't know if he knows he's limited. And you know what? That could be a good thing. Because the only thing preventing the Cowboys from being of the true elite in the NFL is a lack of a passing game. Yesterday, they throw for 380, a career-high 4 touchdowns. They do it without Zeke and without their offensive linemen. Jason Garrett took a big gamble yesterday. When they were up 14-0, he could have pulled Dak. Said, hey, did what we need you to do. This game doesn't matter. He had him play the entire game. The risk you run there is not just injury. It's also that, oh, he's going to blow it. Dak's playing this good game, but now he's going to throw a pick late. Instead, Dak had one of the biggest throws of his career. I know that it can't be one of the biggest throws of his career because the game didn't technically matter, but a 4th and 15 to tie or win a game in any context would have been one of the biggest throws of his career. And they go into the postseason in 2 of their last 3 games with Dak's best passing performances of the year. The game against the Eagles 2 weeks ago, and this game, or 3 weeks ago, and this game here against the Giants.
I mean, it was important for Dak to make sure that he gets some situational football, understanding that he's going to have a tough opponent in Seattle Seahawks coming in to the stadium. But really, for this team to go far, Dak is going to have to go into one of these runs where he's going to have to embrace who he is. He's going to say, forget what the stereotype is or what, you know, mobile quarterbacks are. I'm not going to be a statue because I don't have to. He can help this run game tremendously with the RPOs and being able to hold the backside. He's one of the few quarterbacks that's in the playoffs that can hold, well, not one of the few, but in the NFC that can hold the backside linebacker in the backside defensive end, which will create tremendous seams for Zeke to run through. They're one of the most balanced teams in the playoffs because defensively they're solid, offensively they're solid. They can run the ball. He can take shots down the field, but he's going to have to embrace who he is. And he's playing for a contract extension. So if he wants to get paid that money, if he wants to become that $100 million man, he's going to have to make sure that he takes his team past the division round.
And this is a team that's been great at home all year. And that's what winning the division gets you, is they get another home game. I know this past week was in New York, but their one awful home game was the game that I thought ended their season, the home game against the Titans on Monday Night Football when they got blown out to fall to 3-5. They're one of the handful of teams that you look at them, they're like, oh, they've won 6 of 7, or I guess they were 3-5, so they've won 7 of 8 down the stretch. We know the Colts have won 9 of 10. We know the Ravens have won 6 of 7. There's a few teams that are playing their best football of the year. The Eagles have won 5 of 6 and 3 in a row just to get into the tournament. The Cowboys are one of them. If Dak plays anything like that in the postseason, they can play with anybody. Like go ahead, Jim.
I was gonna say, well, pick the Seahawks because that's next up for them. Can they hang with the Seahawks?
Oh, they can absolutely hang with the Seahawks. Vegas says Cowboys are a slight favorite. I would call them a slight underdog. They can absolutely hang with the Seahawks, but in order to move on past the one home playoff game, they're then gonna have to either beat the Rams or the Saints if they were to get past
Seattle. Well, been there, done that with the Saints, right?
Except for the fact, I don't think that defensive performance is duplicable. Like, I think in order to beat the Saints again, especially especially in New Orleans, they're going to have to get a lot more out of their offense than they got in the first performance on Sunday Night Football or Thursday Night Football.
But you think momentum as a player is a real thing. You feel it. It's a tangible thing, and you can carry it with you into the postseason.
Well, definitely it is. It allows you to punch above your weight class, right? Because it's not about what everybody else thinks about you. It's what you think about yourself. And if they can, you know, continue to keep this momentum and do some things that they feel confident in, and they are put in the right situations. Jason Garrett's got to put, you know, Dak in a situation that where he can maybe complete some early balls early and then take some shots. You know, this is where coaching means a lot in the playoffs, because what happens is you may go against a team that you haven't seen, that you don't really know about, and then you can get surprised by some, not the great players, it's the players that you really don't know about, that you don't hear about.
Right.
For us, it was Brad Smith, right? We got into the playoffs and teams didn't know who he was, and we got a trick play here, explosive play there, and that could be the difference in the playoffs. You know, getting behind and not really understanding the situation, because the game goes so fast in the playoffs. You look up and it's already the fourth quarter.
And once small thing. All year long, Cowboys opponents have basically said, we're not worried about the tight end. We're going to stop Zeke once they got Amari. We're going to try to stop Amari. And the Cowboys haven't been able to make him pay. Yesterday, Blake Jarwin, out of nowhere, has a 3-touchdown game, has a huge game. That he's not going to do that again. But it is something Seattle now can't say, don't worry about the tight end. He's not a threat. They won't throw it to him. He won't make any big plays. And we know they're going to be worried about Zeke. We know Amari has the ability to beat you. And we know that this Cowboys defense can get after the quarterback. Can Dak make the half dozen plays during a playoff game he's going to have to make? Should be noted, Dak's won playoff game. I know they lost it. He was spectacular in that game. He went toe-to-toe with Aaron Rodgers in that playoff game that came down to field goal, field goal, field goal. And if you look back on it, it's one of the best games of his career. So his playoff history is not a negative one, even though it was a loss as a home team. He knows he can play well in the postseason. He knows he just came off his best game of the year. See if they can carry that into the postseason.
Wagner and Zeke is going to be fun to watch because they're on a collision course.
The two best guys in the league at their position going against each other.
Cowboys start the season 3-5. They are now playoff bound. Coming up, who is to blame for the Steelers missing the postseason? Danny Cannell is here to discuss that and more next time.